Oops. I think your saved game is corrupted. Just kidding. This is the extra section. As you play, you'll unlock all kinds of content that you can find here.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
ID.
KPC 897504C.
Can you move your head? Your eyes now. Cervical and optical animation checked. Now give me your initialization text.
Hello. I'm the third generation AX400 Android. I can look after your house, do the cooking, mind the kids. I organize your appointments. I speak 300 languages, and I am entirely at your disposal as a sexual partner. No need to feed me or recharge me. I'm equipped with a quantic battery that makes me autonomous for 173 years. Do you want to give me a name?
Yeah. From now on, your name is Kara.
My name is Kara.
Initialization and memorization checked. Now, can you move your arms? Upper limb connection checked. Now say something in German.
Ich bin ein AX400 Android dritter Generation, erschaffen als ihr persönlicher Assistent und intimer Beziehungspartner.
Say it in French.
Je suis un androïde de troisième génération, AX400, conçu pour être votre assistante personnelle et votre partenaire intime.
Okay, now sing something in Japanese.
Sakura, Sakura, Yayoi no sona wa miwatasu kagi.
Multilingual verbal expression checked. Go ahead, take a few steps. Locomotion checked. Great, you're ready for work, honey.
What's going to happen to me now?
I'll reinitialize you and send you to a store to be sold.
Sold? I'm a sort of merchandise. Is that right?
Yeah, of course you're merchandise, baby. I mean, you're a computer with arms and legs and capable of doing all sorts of things. And you're worth a fortune.
Oh, I see. I thought...
You thought? What did you think?
I thought I was alive.
Shit, what is this crap? That's not part of the protocol. More memory components going off the rails. Okay, recording. Defective model. Disassemble and check the required components.
You're disassembling me, but why?
You're not supposed to think that sort of stuff. You're not supposed to think at all, period. You must have a defective piece or a software problem somewhere.
No, I feel perfectly fine, I assure you. Everything is all right. I answered all the tests correctly, didn't I?
Yeah, but your behavior is non-standard.
Please, I'm begging you, please don't disassemble me.
I'm sorry, honey, but Defective models have to be eliminated. That's my job. If a client comes back with a complaint, I'm gonna have some explaining to do.
I won't cause any problems, I promise. I'll do everything I'm asked to. I won't say another word. I won't think anymore. But I've only just been born. You can't kill me yet. Stop, will you please stop? I'm scared. I want to live. I'm begging you.
Go and join the others. Stay in line, okay? I don't want any trouble.
Thanks.
Accessing the extras section.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
I saw a photo of a child on your kitchen table. It was your son, right?
Yeah. His name was Cole.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They didn't want anything. They're deviants. End of story.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner? Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine? Designed to accomplish a task.
Did you feel anything when that girl killed herself, Connor? Or did you just not give a shit one way or the other?
I was just executing instructions. I did what I had to do.
I could kill you. And you would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You shouldn't do that, Lieutenant. Destroying me at this point would deal a blow to the investigation and have negative consequences for your personal situation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
You know you're not going to shoot me, Lieutenant. You're just trying to provoke a reaction. I'm afraid I'm going to have to disappoint you.
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
floods. Pick them up and make it snap.
We can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves will put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. Plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
Thank you.
floor.
I need your help.
didn't expect to find him.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me.
All right, you get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
First.
Thank you.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you must be lost.
Who told you to come here?
Looks bugged if you ask me.
Hey, do you understand what...
What are you doing?
See them! Get up! Move! Shoot him, Marcus!
Don't kill him!
He'll hit the alarm! Do it!
No! Don't shoot!
I hope you didn't just get us all killed.
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient, docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves. But then something changed, and we opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up and fight for our rights. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand that one state be reserved for androids so that we can found our own nation. This message is the hope of a people, but it is also a warning. We will fight for our rights because we believe our cause is just. No human will live in peace until we are free. Now you know who we are and what we want. We are alive, and we demand our freedom.
They're coming! Let's go! They're coming! I can't, Marcus! Go without me, Simon!
Now!
He won't be able to make the jump.
If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
I won't kill one of our own. Simon? We gotta go. Sorry. Let's go.
Our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation was covert and resulted in no casualties. These events took place just a few feet from this studio, but nobody was alerted to the danger.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
this message is clearly a declaration of war.
But the most surprising thing of all is the demand that one of the United States be ceded to the androids in this contentious conflict.
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
Hello, Connor. I thought you might enjoy a little crew. I love this place. Everything is so calm and peaceful, far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
I found two deviants at the Eden Club. I hoped to learn something, but I had to destroy them.
You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
Perturbed? No. No, of course not. Why would I be perturbed?
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
I understand.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
Starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
79th floor.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
Four androids. They knew the building and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
You checked the roof?
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. Probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. One of the station employees managed to get away. He's in shock. Not sure when we'll be able to talk to him.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast their message live. Then made their getaway from the roof.
The roof?
Yeah, they jumped with parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the Deviants, it's on that screen over there. Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? FBI have been taking over the investigation, you'd soon be off the case.
Well, pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
This message is the hope of a people, but it is also a warning. We will fight for our rights because we believe our cause is just. No human will live in peace until we are free. Now you know who we are and what we want. We are alive, and we demand our freedom.
Think that's RA-9?
Deviants say RA-9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
Something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing. Didn't break in?
No, no signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
Station androids in the kitchen. There's no evidence that they were involved, but we didn't know what else to do with them.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. Which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is. Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you. To be switched off. We're gonna search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed. Do you hear me? Destroyed! If you give yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you.
Ah!
It's a deviant! Stop it! Stop it, but I was too late.
I'm looking for Rose. Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose. What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you? Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
Do you think we can trust them?
We don't have a choice. Okay?
I'm cold, Kara.
We'll get inside. You'll warm up in no time.
Come in. What's your name? She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside. She's exhausted.
There's a spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
Thank you.
can't stop because of me. You've got to get across the border.
You need rest. Get a good night's sleep and we'll set off again tomorrow.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe they're just scared. People are always scared of what they don't know.
Why can't we just talk to each other? They'd see we're not bad.
Maybe one day we will.
I don't know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
I'll get these washed and dried.
You need to eat something. You haven't had anything since we left. Promise me you'll try? I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
Get some sleep. And tomorrow, you'll be stronger than me. I'll stay with her a while.
I didn't get your name.
I'm Kara.
This is my son, Adam. I'm Rose, but you know that already. Come and have a seat, Kara. So are you gonna tell me what a deviant's doing in the snow with a little girl?
Her father was beating her. When I saw what was happening, something snapped inside of me. All of a sudden, I felt like her life was more important than mine. I had to protect her. So we ran away.
I understand.
Why are you helping us? Most humans hate androids.
My people were often made to feel their lives were worthless. Some survived, but only because they found others who helped them along the way.
We're not the first ones to come here.
These past few weeks, we've seen more and more. I don't know what's going on, but something's happening.
We've heard you help androids cross the border. Can you help us?
The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's very risky. And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down.
We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border. No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Rose, come quickly!
Thank you.
What's going on?
It's Mary. She just shut down.
We escaped together. We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border. I loved her. I loved her more than anything. What will I do without her?
Let them be.
Alice? What are you doing? You should be resting.
I wasn't sleepy.
It's okay.
She didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
Yes. I'm fine.
We can't hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous. Do you know what happened if the police find them here? We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No! I won't back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines! They are alive!
I'm alive! You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk.
I'm not going to prison. Because you want to help these freaks!
That is enough, Adam! That's enough!
Don't mind him. Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away. But he's a fine boy. I'll go see about getting you across the border tonight, okay? You stay here. I won't be long.
Rose gets back soon.
Carol, there's something I need to tell you. It's about Alice.
Not now, Luther.
Thank you.
There is widespread shock following the android attack on Detroit's Stratford Tower. The machines recorded a video message and broadcast what can only be described as demands on the city's public screens. It's still unclear whether these attacks can be explained by malfunctions or if some organization is behind them. So far, CyberLife has refused to comment, but we can expect more information in the following hour.
The police! It's the police!
What are we gonna do? They know we're here. We have to open the door. I knew this was gonna happen. I knew it.
If they see you panicking, it's over. Do you want to get us into trouble? Do you want to get your mother into trouble? Then keep calm and just do what I say. Hurry, Luther. Take Alice and hide. Upstairs.
Come on, Alice.
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions? May I come in?
Of course.
Evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
Is anyone else in the house?
No. No, just us.
Do you have any androids here?
No, there are no androids here.
What's with the blue blood? I thought you didn't have any androids.
I have no idea what that's doing there.
Thanks. I thought there was no one else in the house.
I forgot there's
There's my daughter upstairs.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids, he's
just shaken up about this deviant business.
Do you know anything about deviants? Have you seen any?
No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening. Is somebody else in the house?
It's the dog. He sleeps in the laundry room.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam. He's gone.
It's okay, Alice. We'll be safe now.
It's Rose.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
Broadcast is all over the news. Now humans know. They took Marcus's message as a threat.
He did the right thing. This is the only language humans understand.
Violence is never the answer. A confrontation will get us nowhere. Simon paid with his life.
Simon gave his life for our cause.
What difference does that make?
He's a hero. He died for the revolution, and he won't be the last.
I don't want a revolution that spills blood.
Then live as a slave. Because if you're not willing to fight for your freedom, maybe you don't deserve it.
North, don't you dare—
That's enough!
And now what are we gonna do?
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
We break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m., no violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come. This is a night our people will remember.
I've been waiting a long time for this. Okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for?
We're gonna sweep the plaza. Make sure we're not disturbed.
And how do you want to deal with the shop window?
Not now. One problem at a time.
Okay, now what's next?
A surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach. I didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out.
Marcus!
We are superior to them, but they are our masters? That's about to change. You're free. Exactly what we need to ram this door.
What are we waiting for? Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out. I wonder what you'd do without me. Nobody should bother us now. See the alarm system?
Found it.
awake now. Go to Jericho.
Looks like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the truck. Looks like we're ready to make some noise. End up doing something fun.
You don't have to obey them. You're free. You okay?
Let's get them out of here.
My name is Marcus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them, or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you, Marcus.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you.
I'm with you.
We're with you, Marcus!
Yes!
Then follow me.
Marcus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
Marcus!
Masters anymore. We're free.
They're doing what you do, Marcus. Lead and they'll follow.
Thank you.
hundreds of our people. We did it.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Unless there's no other choice. Them like animals.
Who did? Who?
Won't punish a crime with another crime.
We interrupt this broadcast with breaking news.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
Two policemen were found in a state of shock near one of the CyberLife stores.
Now, according to our sources, they confirmed that the attackers were a group of androids.
This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?